I'd have to give that one to Maria Cardona. How do you argue that? Because there is more information. There's, when she says the most transparent, there are, she's given over her taxes. Mm-hmm. Donald Trump hasn't done that. She's given more medical information. How do you argue against that?
Look, none of these candidates are going to some independent doctor. They're all going to their personal physicians, and your personal physician is your advocate. No doctor is going to go out and say, yeah, you know, my patient really treats their body like a spring break rental car. That's never going to happen. So voters are going to have to take a look at what we see, and we're going to have to eyeball it. We're going to have to make that determination for ourselves.
But they need to see something in order to do that.
Yeah, but ultimately we're the ones that decide if they're fit enough to be president. It's an issue that's relevant when it's relevant. It was relevant in 92 when Paul Tsongas was running for president and he'd been battling cancer and said that he was given a clean bill of health. That was relevant with John McCain after spending all of those years at the Hanoi Hilton and people didn't know how his health was. So voters will make that determination.
Okay. Bakari Sellers, do you agree with that?
Well, yeah, because it's relevant now. Donald Trump will be the oldest sitting president if he's elected, and Hillary Clinton will be the second oldest. So it's very relevant today. The fact that, I mean, just sit back and look where we are. I was reading, to comment on Maria's point about false equivalencies, I was reading today where headlines were literally saying that Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton give us a peek into their medical records. That's not the case at all. We were actually going by audience statements who were there watching Dr. Oz, who is a television quack. I mean, that is what we were watching.
And that's
that
a little
is what
harsh on
we
Dr.
were going
Oz.
By.
Oh,
well, that's
easy.
What we were going by.
Yeah.
That is what we were going by. No one actually has the tangible results from his physical.
He's actually a very
no one
respected
knows his medical
cardiologist.
History.
He's a respected
who?
Guy.
Yeah.
And
he's
once
not on the contract with flyers.
But the fact of the matter
takes,
is that he didn't
flyers,
examine. He didn't examine Donald Trump. He has not
correct.
Been Donald Trump's doctor. He has no idea
yeah, Maria,
what this
Trump
means
isn't
vis-a-vis Donald Trump. Donald Trump is 70 years old. Donald Trump is overweight. Donald Trump doesn't
well,
exercise.
He's not the only one.
Donald Trump loves to eat junk food. I mean, this is something that the voters need to see.
He does tweet
and
those pictures with the
John,
Taco Bowl
may,
and with the McDonald's. But
yes.
Let me say this. Let me see. In all seriousness, though. So let's see. This is what he said. His doctor said he would be the healthiest person, individual ever elected. And then today on Dr. Oz, he said he didn't exercise. He said he wants to lose at least 15 pounds, at least, and that he's on medication to control his cholesterol. That doesn't sound like the healthiest individual if you're doing that. As a matter of fact, what did it say? He said 236. The audience member says 267. If he's anywhere in that range for a six foot three man, he's overweight. If he's at 236, and if he's at 260, he is obese. That doesn't sound, Andy, as the most healthiest and fit person.
Well, Don, first look, he looks fantastic to me, and I'll tell you this, he is getting exercise in the sense that he's flying to two or three different states a day, and he walks these lines and shakes voters' hands, and he's moving his arms up and down, so he may not be doing, you know,
Andy,
the
are you really
flex,
saying that?
But
I mean, come on.
That
you can eyeball
as
someone
exercise.
And tell that what their medical history is. Come on, Andy.
No, well, Don, I will tell you this, that over the past, if I could, Maria, for the past 15 months, Donald Trump has been in 2 to 3 different states every single day, 7 days a week, talking to crowds, meeting with people, whereas Hillary Clinton has kept herself, you know, many weeks at a time at small fundraisers with elite donors, and then she collapses like Michael Spinks. You know, the proof is in the pudding here, Don.
Mm-hmm.
Because she had pneumonia, Andy. Let's remember, who was the candidate who complained about having to be in a debate for 3 hours, sweating, leaning on the lectern, and who was the candidate who withstood 11 hours of nonstop questioning from congressional in a congressional hearing?
So listen, just a reminder that this is what Donald Trump. This was in late August, and he said, I think that both candidates, Crooked Hillary and myself, should release detailed medical records. I have no problem in doing so. Hillary? So, I mean, does going on Dr. Oz, does that cut it?
No, it doesn't. But why do we expect anything else? I mean, Donald Trump has been running circles around the media, and this is the troublesome part for a lot of Americans today. This is the media's job. This is journalists' job. That when someone evades you, you have to get to the truth. You can't just sit back and take it for what it's worth and chase down audience members. You have to continuously press these.